Hello to everyone. My name is Dani Carino. I'm here with my first officer, Adrián.
Hello, hi Dani.
And then what? We're going to try to explain all the steps that we're doing for this flight to Punta Cana. So initially what we do is to come to this briefing room, as you see, with our colleagues. And what we have is the paperwork, and then talk with the cabin crew about what we're going to do, all the issues that we're going to have to Punta Cana. And that's it. The main important thing of these things is about to prepare everything on ground in order to have a safe and nice flight. So, let's do it. What we have here is the paperwork, and we have to check both. The first thing is the flight plan. The flight plan, we have here the PLM 6008, which is the flight number. Also, we have origin and destination, okay? And also we have the fuel figures. The fuel figures say about the refuel, taxi, these kind of things that we have to set in order to have all the figures for the flight.
Okay. And as well as in this flight, we take the QRD, key reference data, and we check the weights, people, the crew, in order to check the flight plan with our documents, in order to everything is okay. So it's a work of both that we do together. Yeah. So this is the QRD that says we check here in the briefing.
Also, flight plan have different information. A part of the fuel we have, as Adrián say, the weights, the dry operating. Important in this flight and with this M47 is the payload. We have a high payload, which is nearly 60 tons. So,
because today, Dani, we are with 529 persons on board.
That's it.
So it's a full flight.
That's it. That's a full flight. So we have to check. The important thing here is the zero fuel weight, the maximum takeoff weight, and the maximum landing weight. Okay.
Give me 1 second, please. And we're here. We have the flight dispatch checklist with all the information about the flight times, flight numbers, estimating departure, estimating arrival, expecting payload. That's important for us because we check with the flight plan as well as the flight dispatch that everything is okay. And we have many pages. And the other page as well is the crew that we are 2 pilots today, Captain Dani Canino and myself. Flight time will be around 8 hours 5 minutes. Mm-hmm. And this is the type inbound, so we go to Punta Cana, it's an inbound flight. And with as well the weather tank is 50% of weather in the tanks of the weather tanks. So as well the dry operating weight that we check together is today the dry operating weight is 183.180 that we check in the flight plan. I have to say the same, the thing. And as well to check some field route, field that today for example we have that Dani said before 101.2 tons. And this is we have them in the taxi field for the taxi and contingency, turbulence, weather, everything in the flight dispatch. So now Dani, you mind gonna check the flight plan and
The main thing is to check that the flight plan figures is the same, pretty the same than the flight dispatch briefing. Also, with the flight plan, we have here, as you can see, let's see with the camera, our route. And our route had to be settled down, and we have to check that every point, for example, we have Gunti, we have the 3820 West, Docas, all these points are the same, like in our route, and as you see, goes to the 40 West and then goes to the 50 West and 5C. So we have to check every point with every distance then on flight. So that's very helpful to us to check with Jepsen about the points and every figures. Also we have here the route information which gives us about the communication rules, operational rules, flight rules, all these kind of things. So it's very helpful to us.
Another important thing is as well we have our iPad. But every information or the information is in the paper, the flight dispatch. And as well, we check with Dani because we are crossing the Atlantic. We check the not tracked information today. It's a flight from Madrid to Punta Cana, so it's not tracked at all. But we have to know, it's important to know, the TMI indicator. Today is 348. This is an important thing because control sometimes asks about the TMI, the TMI. So today is 348. It's not affect us because it's not tracked today, but it's important to know it.
Okay. The next thing is the weather. Weather, we check the meta, the DAFOR of Madrid, also the same as the alternate that we have it, because we have to check also, like La Paz, like Santo Domingo, and also the, of course, the destination Punta Cana weather, meta and DAFOR, and any NOTAMs, notification to Airman, that we can affect to us. So that's pretty much what we do in the briefing, checking the flight plan, checking the weather, checking the route, NOTAMs, alternatives, all these kind of things. It's long flight, it's 8 hours, so we have to manage all this information in order to everything settle down and be prepared for everything. Okay.
And I think that it's, the orientation report is an important thing, because now with RMP we need to know that we have enough coverage with the GPS for perform the arrival at Punta Cana and departure here, because we're going to perform another departure and in Punta Cana RMP arrival. Maybe will be the runway C-8 in Punta Cana. And as well today we are full passengers, expecting payload 9,800 kilograms, but it's important to check that the captain already did it, is a special load notification to captain, because today you have 400 kilograms and a Comat and 78 kilograms. So this is, and we check as well in the LIR where is this load.
That's it. So mainly these kind of things, as Adrian said, with the arrival, because it's a aeronav approach, it's not an ILS, so it's important about to check about all these GPS requirements. And that's pretty much what we do. So let's next step is to talk with the cabin crew.
And now it's just Danny Carino is now the captain of the flight. He tell me now which will be the final field before start, that we are away as 102 tons. And now we say to the guys that the final field ramp will be 102,000 tons for the flight to Punta Cana. And this is now we have the field and the final figures. We pass it to the, our compressor of staff and for the final load of the aircraft.
So we go to the briefing cabin crew in order to explain what we have for Punta Cana. Let's go. Okay, hello everyone.
Hello.
Well, you know Adrian, you know me. So the only thing about this briefing is about flight time. 8 hours, okay? We have turbulence moderate on 5 hours from departure, okay? The weather is nice, partly cloudy, nearly 20 degrees, so you know Punta Cana is nice. And that's all. I hope you have a good flight. Anything, any question, you ask to me or Adrián.
We are lucky today because we are lucky because the crew is a fantastic crew. It's impossible to learn. Thank you very much. So we are very happy to go to Punta Cana. It's a good destination. With sun, beach. But before I had to jump. The cabin crew is expecting for go to the aircraft, prepare the cabin for the passengers, and they go to check as well the catering, the emergencies, and they go to do the walk around. So you happy, you want, you can with me, with Danny? No, maybe with me. We had the first officer today, we go to the walk around, so you're invited with me to do the walk around.
And as everybody see, it's longer the way to the aircraft than the flight. It takes too long to go there.
We'll go on board.
Let's go to Punta Cana.
Come with me.
Sí, vamos a ir quitando.
Remember, you have to do together the walk around.
Sequence gonna be 1, 2, 3, and 4.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4.
With a manual start.
Okay.
I set my side number 1. Also, for the departure, we're gonna have ATM. We're gonna reduce the power to at least 42 degrees to take 366.8, which is like nearly 50 tons, no?
Yeah, that's it.
I
do confirm with you, do check is for 3-6 left in Madrid, Pratt & Whitney 4056, flaps 20,
check.
Air conditioning on,
check.
Temperature now is 10 degrees, we can maximum operate, and we assume 42 degrees, that we are agreed both, and we can take 366.8 by climb 376.3, so 366.8 is good enough for us, okay?
Perfect. Okay, and flap 20. So 20, and then the SID.
X-ray, bonjour, go ahead.
It's gonna be the we have set on the box. Parity to X-ray. Parity to X-ray is the 10-3 Charlie, which says the minimum crank gravity 6.4 until Attila.
We're gonna
do it because we have 15 tons.
Okay.
Also, check about the in the next page.
Here.
My Delta 016, 3,600 at above.
Check.
My Delta 017, 4,300 above. My Delta 040, 8,000. Avila 12,000. Longa 245 at
check.
Then to Bart.
And Squawk 1434.
The back is closed. Okay.
Air France 130 X-ray. The clearance is correct. Report fully ready.
Here in plan mode, we have Bardi, sorry, now, we have Delta 16, my Delta 17.
Yes, I check it with you, yeah.
8,000 and 2,000, vale. Hola.
Iberia Express 940, muy buenas. Autorizados a Tenerife, no.
Cerramos.
Salida Villatobas, 4 Lima de la pista 3, okay. Izquierda.
Continue with the briefing. Well, this is the standard one.
Yeah.
Check altitudes. It's on the box.
Yeah.
Setting all the altitudes set. Okay, fix. We have it. On the map mode.
Now, just to confirm with you, in the fix, I put in the minimum sector altitude with valid 2 X-ray is 10,100. And as well, for the entering Atlantic, the fix number 2 is the level 250 for the check altitude before to enter in the Atlantic.
Mucho sol y mucho. Cuidadito los pies, ¿eh?
The RMP will be a RNAV departure. If for party to X-ray will be a required navigation performance 1.100, actual 0.004, so we are okay inside.
Emergency briefing,
please.
Any takeoff warning, configuration, windshield ahead. Fire engine failure, thrust lever idle, auto throttle disconnect, speed brake, and manual braking. From 80 to B1, windshield fires or engine failure, thrust lever idle, disconnect, auto throttle, speed brake. If auto brake ACAS message is shown, you just tell me and I will do manual braking, and if able, reverse symmetrical.
Okay.
Okay. From B1, continue. Take off, important gear up. 400 feet AGL minimum for the memory items. I do memory items for pilot flying, to job for pilot monitoring.
Okay, copy.
And as follows is the Sierra Sierra Yankee, and it shows here. Sierra Sierra Yankee, outbound to the 009.
Okay, that's the navigation display check.
009, 5 miles, outbound, and then holding.
Okay.
Copy. So after climb, clean the plane and do all the memory items. We follow the SID of engine failure. We talk with the control about what to do and what to expect. Then we go to the QRH.
Okay.
And we decide what to do. Okay?
Okay. Check it, okay? And it's okay.
So, zero fuel weight please. Actual is 238.5.
238.5 zero fuel weight. So, we have a gross weight of 39.6.
Copy.
Happy? Okay.
Enough. Fairly enough.
So, we assume, confirm, 42, right?
Yes.
Assume temperature 42. For climb one, is okay for you?
Sí, espérate.
Ground to cockpit.
Go ahead.
Just for information, this at 25.
Okay.
Thank you.
42 degrees Celsius. Climb one for 145, 146, 145, okay?
1341. And confirm your ascent 7.
Take off 23,000, engine acceleration 1,500 feet, throw reduction 1,500, climb one, okay? And BRM for B1 will be 147, is okay?
Yes, 147.
147.
I'm gonna be the pilot flying, so I do the first check, but it's okay.
Okay, that's all right.
Same thing, enough, about 5 miles, okay. And Sierra Yankee, it's identified, okay. And we have here on Parajas.
Okay, copy, thank you.
No pasa nada.
So,
IRS GPS 3.
Okay, so there's the flows. Michael?
Parajas, Sierra Yankee, identified.
Thank you, copy.
Okay.
Thanks. Michael?
Please.
Barajas, buenos días, Pullman 6008.
Pullman 26008, clear to my Delta Papa Charlie, Punta Cana, runway 36 left, standard Bardi 2 X-ray, walk 2603.
Confirm 2603.
Okay, Pullman 6008, information Charlie, 747 decision, Punta Cana, thank you, Bardi 2 X-ray, runway 36 left, on squawk 2603.
6008 is correct, call me back when ready.
Call you back when ready, Pullman 6008.
Okay, now we have our clearance to Punta Cana, so we'll be for Bardi 2 X-ray as pretty before, run with 36 left, and everything is good. So we are going now to start the our engines for Fantax engines to Punta Cana. There we go.
Ground cockpit.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, go ahead.
Okay, confirm, doors closed, area clear, mid pressurized hydraulics.
All doors are closed, all shocks are removed, no equipment on the aircraft, and you are clear to pressurize the aircraft.
And now it's time to prepare the aircraft for pressurize, and we have to check and do some work before engine starts. So there we go. Michael, okay? It's exciting.
The disturbance in the briefing with the calls, but it's okay.
Yeah. Fuel engines.
Okay.
One pack up. Beacon. A checklist.
And I forgot to say, status of the plane is okay. Okay. Let you run.
and we check as well the mitigations.
See the ground cockpit?
Yes, go ahead.
Okay, we're gonna start with engine number one.
You are clear to start engine number one.
Before start check, spark brake.
Spark brake, set.
MCP.
MCP, we have 169.001.30,000.
Takeoff speeds.
Takeoff speed, we have V1147, VR159, V2169.
V1147, VR159, V2169. City of prepper flight.
Complete.
Complete. The man pumps.
Auto, yaws.
Pax.
One on.
VCOM.
Both.
Harness and door.
Secure.
Secure. Before start check is complete, so you're clear for engine start.
Okay, we can start engine number one?
Yes, you are clear to start engine number one.
So okay. There we go to start engines. Let's go.
535 EGT, start check. Engine number one.
Okay, starting engine number one. Manual start.
Check.
N2.
Check.
Engine number one rotating.
Copy.
Oil press.
Fuel on. Tight. EGT.
Check. So now we are starting the engines, and today we started for engine number one in the left side of the aircraft, then we have two, three, and four.
And one.
Four fantastic engines. Check.
Admiral Charles 2469, request stop.
No trans 2469, strap approved, Kinich 1018, hold position and contact apron 121.705. Bye.
Start approved, QNH 1018 and call 1705 for push.
Start engine number two.
Yes,
you are clear
to start engine number two. Starting engine number two.
Standing by for two.
There you go, number two.
Ambo 259XA, lowest 99 so for an Embraer 35.
Abraham, Senna 9, Embraer Lake.
Ambo 529XA, clear to Malaga, runway 36 left.
Engine number two,
Toba, Lima, Quok. 5103.
Jet Malaga, runway 36 left. Villa Toba for Lima departure, squawk 5103. Hamburg 529.
Check.
Number 529, clearance is correct.
Madrid, Europa 51 Whiskey X-Rays. Buenas tardes, en stand Tango 39, ATR 72500. Con información Delta, listos copiar a Sevilla.
Decidido, le llamo Break Express 3940 de Torre.
I delete the cash message in the...
Barajas y... Bueno, voy a ir. Express 3940, parking 332, requerimos puesta en marcha, por favor.
Echo slow,
3940, puesta en marcha aprobada con H1018. Mantenga posición y llame 123... 255, buen día.
50%
marcha aprobada, 1018, mantenga posición, 123255, igualmente buen día, gracias. ¿Y usted en
el number 3?
Yes, we are clear.
Whiskey a Sevilla por la izquierda, salida Villa Tobas, 4 Lima. Responda 5165.
En Chu.
Villa Tobas, 4 Lima, 3 izquierda, respondo 5165. El Europa 51 Whiskey R.
51 Whiskey R, correcto.
Oil press.
Engine number 3 rotating.
Now it's coming, EGT, and one.
Yeah.
May start engine number 4?
Yes, repeat, 4.
Okay, and we start the last engine, number 4. There we go. Starting at number 4. And 2.
rotating.
Copy.
Oil press.
Check.
Fuel on.
Check.
Time. EGT.
Check.
One.
Check.
Madrid, muy buenas, del hermano 74 y entiendo.
FE check was fantastic.
Tenemos un 7-4 Yankee Alfa, buenas, adelante.
Buenas tardes, en el 3-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-2-
the radar when you told me, Danny.
Later on. Okay. We go to the
taxi.
More time on the street. No, no.
Taxi by Charlie 5 Alpha and
next one.
Go 5.
Copy?
Copy, yeah.
Okay.
And an Alpha Charlie uniform, request
next one.
9-0 Charlie uniform, taxi by Charlie 5,
Prof.
Alpha.
Charlie 5, Prof. Alpha, Ryanair, 9-0 Charlie uniform.
Pullman 6008, please keep way northbound, Norwegian traffic coming from the left, with
side city. Okay, traffic inside, we're giving way to Norwegian and Pullman 6008. Ryanair 9-0
Charlie uniform.
Copy.
On Alpha,
so
give way.
We have two.
Seven, inside.
Seven.
Follow the traffic.
All the safety information for this aircraft is found at the car located in the seat pocket in front of you. It is important that you read it before takeoff. If you have any questions, we're here to help you. We remind you that you must at all times follow the indications given on the signs, illuminated signs, and the indications given by the cabin crew.
Okay, so we follow the Norwegian,
yeah,
and the Ryanair is following us.
Yeah, okay. Is clear.
Check.
Golf 1,
Mike, hold for the
Golf
5.
Golf 1, then Mike, no Golf 5, no chance, 2469.
Pullman
6008,
continue following
in
traffic, Golf 1, Mike,
hold
for the Golf
5. Pullman 6008,
I read
you one, sir.
6008, how about now?
Excellent, sir.
Okay, still following the Norwegian traffic via Golf 1 Mike, hold short of Golf 5.
Thank you, sir. By Norwegian Golf 1 Mike 5. Pullman 6008, thank you.
So follow Golf 5.
Shutter, left side, and join Mike, okay?
Golf 1.
To Mike.
Mike, hold short of Golf 5.
To Mike 5, Golf 5, okay?
Golf 1 Mike, short of Golf 5.
So we'll continue straight ahead, then left to join Mike, and to until Golf 5.
Okay.
Now left. Okay, Danny, echo information, QNH 1018, broken 3200, okay, 11 degrees, and everything is same.
Now we can check the radars.
Okay, I'm going to check.
Radar
test in progress.
2469 for the Golf 5, 12198. 16008 on Golf 4, you will give way Europa traffic 727 coming from the right.
Okay, giving way to the Europa and Golf 4, Puma 6008. I'm going to try again with the test.
6008, this now with the Sky King follow.
6008.
Monitor radar display.
Here is.
Go around, wind shear ahead. Wind shear ahead, wind shear ahead.
Go, too nice, yeah?
And just to say to the people that this plane is too big, so we have to take care on the ground.
Yeah.
Doing the taxiing.
We're caring about this, eh?
The turns,
yeah.
Everything. So.
So actually, we are, guys, hello again. Actually, we are taxiing with approximately 340 tons of weight. So we have to go slowly and be careful because the aircraft is too huge. And the most important thing is to check outside. The winds are okay. Yellow line.
Muy buenas, si me aceleran pueden ir alfa a la derecha. Se incorporan a Mike en cuanto puedan. Juliet corto de X-ray.
So Danny, you're gonna take off with train or weather? Would you prefer?
Weather.
Okay.
Buenas,
so I will take train, okay?
Uniform, bravo.
Sí, So now we are approaching to runway 36 left, and we departed to the north of Madrid, and then going to a left, and to Party, and then to Portugal, to Lisboa, to entering the Atlantic. We are exciting for taking off and going to Punta Cana. Dani? We are?
Of course. Plataforma.
Better weather than here.
121980.
Okay, now it's fair, right?
Madrid, muy buenas, Europa 829 Merindia, rodando por Alfa.
29 Merindia, continúe Alfa 13.
Por Alfa, Alfa 13, Europa 829 Merindia.
Hello, Madrid, no soy.
And Romeo 5 is there, to the left.
And,
yes.
Maybe we're going to be so busy doing the things we do now that before take-off check.
Okay. Before take-off check, this is flaps.
20 in the box, 20
and 20 green. Briefing?
Complete.
And cabin is standby for the cabin, okay? Before take-off check, is standing by for the cabin.
So, call them.
Pullman 6008, contact tower 118.080
with tower, Pullman 6008, buenas tardes.
They forgot it.
Torre, buenas tardes, Pullman 6008, Romeo 5, 36 left.
Pullman 6008, muy buenas. Please take Barty to X-ray SID. And line up and wait 36 left.
Lining up and wait 36 left, Barty to X-ray for departure, Pullman 6008. I'm gonna call, that's okay?
Yeah, I have radios. Call 1-2.
Yeah. Maggie, sí. ¿Me escuchas? ¿Ahora? No, me escuchas, ¿verdad? Vale, la cabina asegurada enlazada, ¿verdad? Dámela, por favor, gracias. Dani, cabin ready, ¿ok?
Okay. So clear, confirm, 3 left.
Yeah, 3 left.
Right clear.
Right clear, left clear.
Body to X-ray.
Yeah.
Okay. Line up, confirm.
Yeah, lining up and wait, 3 left.
Legs on your page.
Yeah, now.
Copy.
Kevin, can you enter the runway for takeoff? Good flight.
Weather my side.
Okay, before takeoff check is complete, Danny. Okay, I'm standing by for. And now, guys, fasten your seat belts. Because we are about to take off for Punta Cana.
Pullman 6008, wind 1505 knots, runway 36 left, you're clear for takeoff.
Danny, ready? Clear for takeoff, 36 left, Pullman 6008.
Ready?
Ready, Danny.
Vamos. Let's go. So, time?
Time?
110.
Pullman 6008. Adiós, gracias. Left in command.
Okay.
Madrid, buenos días. Pullman 6008, heavy body to X-ray.
Pullman 6008,
radar contact,
climb level
1601. Okay, climbing to level 160 for information. I read you one. Okay, the stealth client to level 160, Pullman 6008 heavy.
160,
I confirm. Climb, level 160.
Pullman 60, Pullman 6008 heavy. Okay, 160 set, okay, Danny?
Check.
Climb one, check. Do you hear okay or not?
Yeah.
Not too good, eh?
Okay.
Little bit, roughly. Not too good. Okay, next one is Celsius 40,000, check.
Check.
Vale.
That pressure is okay.
Maybe in the turn I'm gonna do flap 5, okay? It depends of the altitude and the turn.
Okay.
It's not too hot, it's cold, but I will see.
225, accelerate him.
Check. On the turn had to be 1,000.
Yeah, 1,000.
Flap 10.
Speed check. Flap 10. Enable next altitude, Danny. May I cancel?
You cancel, so I do a speed intervention.
Check.
And I do whatever what I told you. Okay, flap 5 with 220.
Check.
Flap 5.
Speed check. Thrust 5.
And can you put me climb thrust?
Sure. Climb thrust.
Check.
Set. Okay.
Okay. 133.125. Okay. 133.125. Okay.
To be less speed 1,000 for the 8,000.
Yeah, check.
Stars at 33 Charlie, turn left heading 160 degrees.
At 33 Charlie, left turn heading 160.
220. 8,000, vale?
Check.
Check.
Cumplido.
Now 258.
Stabilize 1,000-2,000 above.
Check.
So it's okay.
Now, accelerated.
Yeah. Thank you.
Good morning, brother. I am 1,5,2,9,6,3 on the Vianduba for Lima. 4,000 climbing, 30,000.
America 4,2,9,8,3, radar contact left, 11,1,6,0.
I'm sending 1,6,0, I am 1,5,2,9,8,3.
Descends
at 33 Charlie, descends level 140. Namanda
heading
1,70. Speed check,
flight 1.
Admit Charlie, descends flight level 140 and right turn heading
170. 10,000.
Check. Flaps up.
Speed checks. Flaps up. Above MCA, okay?
Seatbelts and lights.
Okay. Do you want to something and fix the fix now?
Not yet. Later on.
I'm going to set it in automatic.
Okay. After takeoff.
Pullman 600, climb
to level 240. Climb to maintain level 240, Pullman 2600, heavy.
240 set.
Vale, check. Pues after takeoff is gear up and off, flaps up, altimeters.
We go to 240.
So you wanna go with the transition or wanna wait?
We go now.
Okay. Transition set, passing 115. Stop.
Same.
Okay. After takeoff checklist is completed.
Come.
Okay, clear terrain, I'm gonna go there with you. Expecting 340 today because we are too heavy. And we continue with Madrid control. In 10 minutes we contact with Lisboa, no? With Lisboa control,
Lisboa.
To enter the Ocean Atlantic to continue our route to Punta Cana. Magnific.
Madrid, muy buenas, Lisboa 9 Golf Delta, descending flight level 210, Orbis.
Easy 49 Golf Delta, radar contact, continue descent, level 170.
So Danny, just one question to confirm with you, is optimum is level 325. For the Oceanic, which level do you want?
Well, max is 36, no?
Yeah, maximum is 36 today.
We can take 34, 35. Whatever you want.
Okay. So we are talking about which level we are going to fly in the ocean. Because as I told before, we are heavy today, 340 tons. Maximum will be 385, but 334 for a Punta Cana. And the flight level optimum will be for the cross the Atlantic, will be flight level 330. And then with the time we go up for flight level 34, 35, 360. Information. We are passing flight level 180. They are calling us from the cabin in order to that everything is okay here. And we are climbing at a speed of 3-4-5 knots at 2,100 feet per minute. So it's excellent. With 3-8 tons that weight that you have now, climbing at 3-4-1 knots and 2,000 feet per minute is incredible. It's the Jamba 747-400. She's coming.
Start the service.
On behalf of Wamos Air and of the entire crew, I would like to welcome you on board. When we reach our cruising altitude, we will offer you our land service, which we hope you will enjoy. In addition, once this service has ended, we we will make available to you a range of food choices with a selection of hot and cold products that you can find on our in-flight sales magazine. If you wish to rest, please keep your seatbelt fastened and visible during the entire flight to prevent the crew from needing to wake you in the case of turbulence. Please do not hesitate to contact us if you're necessary.
Sadani.
Direct to Bardi.
State. Bardi on top.
Check.
Within a family, may execute.
Check.
Execute. And please switch for me 126525 5th Madrid, right? Thank you. So Bardi is okay? Good, thank you. Madrid, buenas tardes, Pullman 600 heavy, climbing to level 240, looking for higher.
Pullman 2600 Madrid, radar contact, climb to level 310.
Climb to maintain level 310, Pullman 2600.
310.
Check, 310 set.
So you were talking about?
Sorry, we're talking about with my new friends, that we are about 3-5 times, and we are climbing at 3-4-5 knots per minute, and with 2,000 feet per minute. So it's incredible, this aircraft, huh?
For so heavy, yes.
That's it.
It's like 3... We took off with 340. How many tons? It was 3 less, no?
Yeah.
337.
Buenas tardes, radar contact.
Tons.
And 2 minutes ago, while I waiting with all of you, the senior cabin crew called us in order to say that everything downstairs is okay. And they are calling with the captain in order to they're going to start the service. And of course, everything is good here, good weather, everything looks good. So the seatbelts are off, and we continue our trip to Punta Cana.
Let's see, with the 25, no?
Yeah, and now the captain say we are approaching flight 250, that we have a check for entering the RVSM, the DIOS Vertical Separation Minima, and MNPS, Minimum Navigation Performance Specification. This is a rules that have to comply, that we comply 747, the pilots qualify to enter in the Ocean Atlantic. And I have to check a flight 250 that altimeters and the standby are in range, are with the war. The altimeter primary and the standby are okay. So flight 250, we're approaching now. We check that everything is okay for entering Atlantic. We cannot enter with 200 difference between the first, the captain, altimeter, and myself. So we're approaching flight 250.
You got it?
Danny, flight 250, top.
20 below.
20 below, okay?
030, bye-bye.
And this is like nearly 180 feet below.
You say 20 up, 20 down?
20 down. No. If you want, I can stay with the radios with Madrid.
Yeah.
And I think this is Santa Maria, no?
Yes. I'm going to call entering party. I'm going to take the communication log, okay?
Okay.
You have the control and communication for a while. I'm going to take the communication log.
I have control and communication.
I'm back in a minute. I'm going to take the communication log for the Oceanic and the chart as well for throughout our cruise trip to Punta Cana. So guys, now we are climbing to initially cruise. Will be flight 310 because of Lisboa doesn't allow us to go up. So we maintain 310 for about 15, 20, 30 minutes, depending on the control. We request 330, that will be optimal flight level today. And we need to request 30 minutes before entering the ocean, our oceanic clearance. So we share the task, so he's flying, and he takes the radio. And I will call to Santa Maria to request flight level 330 for the oceanic, and Mach 84, that is our speed. Danny, 1,000.
1,000, check.
Lisbon Pullman 600 heavy, approach level 310.
Pullman 26008, continue climbing
to
level 330 final in Madrid.
Okay, climbing to level 330 final in Madrid, Pullman 6008. are flight level 340, looking for 350. That's around 10 kilometers. And we are Mach 84 to our destination Punta Cana. This is a very smooth flight. No, Danny?
Until now it's smooth.
Until now it's smooth. And we passed it 50 minutes ago, Lajes, Azores, Santa Maria. And we are heading west 270 to Punta Cana, our destination.
Yeah. And just to show them, this is the route that we saw on the briefing plan that we told you. And this is our position. So as you see, La Paz is behind. Okay, Lajes. And the good thing here is that we're going now with Santa Maria, and then on the 40 West we go New York. In Atlantic, we have several areas on which we have to take contact. We do it by VHF, but on the remote areas we have to do it by by HF or by anything that we call CPDLC. Which means that we can get contact by GPS with the signal. So in that manner, we are always in contact with them, because of course VHF, they have a range of 250 miles. So if we were flying in the 40 West, 50 West, in these remote areas, we need or HF, which is a more coverage.
Danny, sorry, yes. Sorry for interrupting you. Please, may you confirm which altimeters, which altitude reads your altimeter for the check, please?
Don't interrupt me. 3400.
3400, okay. Thank you.
Okay.
Sorry,
No. Okay.
That's it.
And that's it. So we have Sandwick, New York, all these kind of places, areas that we can go and go through. These are the tracks. It's like the highways. The north goes from America to Europe. We'll see. So for us, the Jepsen is very useful, because also if we get to route info, we get on the, for example, this case, 67. 67 say communication procedures, New York flight level, MNPS. So we have, you see, you can check between the flight levels which number we can contact if we have to lose the contact with them. So it's very useful for us. Also here you see number 7 MNPS, and then for example here when we approach to Tarmo later on, we have Tarmo, it's a communication procedures. You see, all aircraft on IFR flight plan in the San Juan should contact 200 miles. So it's like they give us step by step what we should do, what frequency we should contact, and all these kind of things. So it's useful to fly in these areas, because it's not like flying by in Europe. In Europe, you get mostly of the time each of contact. So in this area, also you have to be a plan B. Okay? Also we have the alternate, no, Adrian?
Second?
Our alternate, which is here, no?
That's it, yes. In the fixed, it's Lima, Papa, Lima, as well. Second is...
Yeah.
Tango, X-ray, Kilo, Foxtrot, that is Bermuda.
That's okay. It. So as you see, it's here, on Magenta. And also the other one that put Adrian is this one. It's the closest airport that we have it. So in the case that we have to divert, depends on the kind of issue, we can go there. Or we can go to Madrid back, or we continue to Punta Cana, or we continue, it depends. Also, we can call them by SATCOM, no? If we have any issue, we can call them by SAT, no? We got to call the office, maintenance, all these kind of things. We cannot call by mobile telephone.
It's a good deal in case of
Or something.
were your first flight here in Guam, sir? Do you remember?
I think was...
Because I remember about you, it's 14 years ago, huh? But I can't remember which one was your first flight here in Pullman Tour, now Guam, sir.
I think was when we started here, no? In 2003.
You started here in 2003?
Yeah.
So 16 years, huh?
Yeah.
I am here for 14 years. You are older than me.
Wow. I'm too old now.
Okay.
I start young and then I'm too old.
Okay.
Yeah, but more 16 years.
Your first flight was in for Cancun, from Punta Cana?
It was this one, Madrid-Punta Cana. But I remember it was the flight with our first chief, the initial boss. So he was flying, and I remember it was the way back, Punta Cana, Madrid.
And you remember how do you feel on the first flight? It was the classic one, the 747-200 with the engineer, right?
Uh-huh,
okay.
With an engineer. Wow. And they were, I think it was all the old guys from Iberia, you know, the retirement guys, pilots. They were very, very experienced people and very, very nice.
And many, I think they told you many histories, huh?
They were in Iberia like 35 years or 30 years. They were there all their lives also in Iberia. So they have histories for everything. They know the plane a lot, the mechanics and the captains. And for me, it was like a good, you know, like a instruction, not only about flying, also about living. They would explain me and teach me how to...
But the question is, how do you feel the first flight that you flew the 747 at 200, the jumbo? How it was?
Big jumbo.
How old are you? How old were you?
24, and I remember, I didn't expect to take off. I expect that he will do the go to Punta Cana and come back.
Yeah.
He don't tell me nothing. And when we were sitting, I remember he just lined up and say, "Hey, Danny, you ready?" I say, "Ready for what?" I say, "Ready for took off the plane." I say, "No." No, I say, "Yeah, yes, of course, I'm ready." And I remember he put the thrusters and everything. Say, "Okay, you're going to took off and you're going to do the flight."
So your first flight here was with 24 years old. And how old are you now?
41.
41, wow, alive. Okay.
So that's it.
It's very nice, honey. Very, very nice.
Well, I mean, it's not different, but it's like you, know? You've been in you've been started from a cabin crew.
Yeah.
And then, what?
My career, I finished my pilot career, and I started a master in aeronautic. And when I finished the aeronautic master, I started in Guam, sir, like a vicario, no? No experience at all.
No.
Nobody paid me, but I was very, very happy because I am in the world that I want to be in the aviation. So it was a sensational experience for me with 23 years old, 22 years old. And from the beginning to now, it was around 15 years. I was growing up in the company because I was working like a flight attendant as well, the 747-200.
I
was working in the flight student here, the 747-400. Remember, I flew with you many times here, sitting here, like a flight student. It was a very nice experience. And I think I had not many hours to fly this aircraft. So I went to another company for 2 years. But in the meantime, I was in the company flying a small aircraft, an Embraer 120 Brazilian one, excellent aircraft. I was working in the operation department in Guam, sir, doing some papers, revalidation of the license of pilots.
You've been in all departments.
That's it. Yeah, that's it. Now I'm in the station department. And after I have enough experience to fly this aircraft, I come back. I did it terribly the 747-400. You was my instructor, my ground instructor, 11 years ago.
You had bad luck for that.
That's it. It was nice experience. And now I'm here with you flying to Punta Cana together, huh?
Yeah.
It's from 11, but I started very young as well, and I've been in the operation department, office department, instruction department, flight attendant, flight student, everything. But it was very nice because I have an experience from all the departments.
And that's good because you see all the departments how they work.
Yeah. And another thing, Danny, you remember when we started here 15, your case, 16 years ago, in my case, 14 years ago, how the company was and how the company is now? Because now we are 5747-400 and 7 Airbus 330. Okay, yeah. And now it's going to come another Airbus 330-300. So total will be 8 Airbus 330 and 5747-400. And all the kind of operation that we did, all the operation that we are doing, is incredible that the company growing up, huh?
A lot.
We have many customers, many clients, more than 145 countries visited, more than 40 clients, more customers working for them.
And you know the good thing about this job, as the WAMOS is about how WAMOS can put any plane, anywhere.
Any place, yeah.
You can fly everywhere.
In one moment. Because you are, for example, in Madrid, and suddenly you receive a phone. Hello, Danny, what are you doing?
Yeah.
Oh, I am with whatever. Because be ready, be prepared, because in 3 hours you take off, you do Madrid, London Gatwick, you stay in London Gatwick for one night, and then London Gatwick, New York.
But you know, in the office what they say is that the difference between this company and other companies is the flexibility that we have, that we can put a plane with cabin crews, pilots, maintenance, in any place, anywhere.
Yeah,
and that is short time. So our response time is very short in compared with other airlines.
That's
the important thing. And also I think is what we like, no?
Yeah, that's it.
To fly short haul, long haul, and fly everywhere. Only specific routes.
And that's it. We are a worldwide operation company, very flexible, and as well WAMOS Air has has a lot of flexibility to open new routes for the clients.
No, that's true.
It's a thing that is amazing here, because from 15 years ago to now, the company growing a lot, offering to customers very good service. And
for example, what is the most strange place that you've been flying to?
Maybe
or remote area?
Maybe in Asia. Maybe I have to think about, because I have been in many places with WAMOS Air. But for me, Bangkok was excellent.
Bangkok, eh?
Bangkok was an incredible city, incredible nice city, crazy city. And I was 4 years ago fly from Madrid straight to Phuket. And then we go to Phuket to Bangkok. It was a charter flight for another customer. We spent 5 days here, and the flight was so nice.
Yeah.
Danny, sorry for a moment. Hey guys, I had to wear it now, approaching to position 30 north, 30 west, 36 north, 30 west. I had to take the wings, temperatures, feel to record our flight plan. It's our business. So next point will be 34 north, 40 west, that is New York with the FIR, okay?
Okay.
We have to put as well the CPDLC, the Kilo Zulu Whiskey Yankee. Please, make you coffee, which is the field that you have, please, the remaining?
The lowest one is 61.7.
Second, please?
61.7.
Okay, 61.6.
0.7.
0.7. And what about the field, is it?
40.5.
Okay, 40.5. So, guys, now, flight level 340, we are going to climb flight level 350 in 10 minutes. So, regarding our calculations, we use it in 3 hours, 10 minutes flight time, 40 tons of fuel, and remaining fuel is 61 tons. We have more, 4 hours and a half more to get our arrival, and we estimated to board about 85 tons. And now, we burn 40 tons, so in 3 hours our fuel usage is 40 tons, 0.5.
For example, I saw yesterday an Airbus 320.
Yes.
It goes per hour, I think it's 3 tons, and this plane is 10 tons.
10 tons per hour, yes.
And the 320 is at 3 tons.
Because Airbus 320 as well is a small aircraft than this.
No.
For example, an Airbus 330.
I think, I'm not really sure, maybe
it's
six.
Around 6 tons, 5 tons, huh? Because I think in the, with Airbus 330, I was talking last day with the 330 pilots, he told me that flying from Madrid to Punta Cana, the fuel is about, the rock fuel, so the fuel that they have to use from Madrid to Punta Cana is 62 tons, approximately.
Nearly half.
More or less. But this is two engines, it's 320 passengers, and this kilo-zero mic 747-400, we are carrying out 529 passengers.
Yeah, but it's for example, the fuel, the maximum fuel that we can carry out is 165, no? 164.
Once again, the
maximum fuel that we can carry.
Yes.
More or less. With the tail.
With tail, yeah. With
more or less.
With the tail, yeah.
And a 320 goes maximum takeaways nearly 80 tons. So nearly a fuel, we can take 2 320s. Nearly a fuel.
Uh-huh. In the company,
the first year of the hatch.
First hatch.
The first hatch.
How many hatches did you do?
A lot. When we started on 2008, no, the
yeah,
hatch.
Yeah, that's it. 2008.
And we still all the years, no?
Yeah.
But I think the first hatch was the best, in order because we didn't know what was that. It was very far away, with different culture, different people, and all that. And for us was like marvelous, seeing all these places. Remember, we went to Bali.
Yeah, that's it. Bali, very nice place. Bali is a very nice place to stay, yeah? And
very
Jakarta.
Nice.
Yeah.
And also the flights were very demanding, but it was very nice experience. The first hatch, then of course all the hatch was nice, but the first one is like, it impressed me a lot.
That's it. Do you like, what do you prefer? Fly westbound? Or fly eastbound, fly Asia or fly to America. Because when we're there, we are lucky because we flow to the east, to the west, to the north, to the south. What do you think? What do you prefer?
It depends on the destination.
It depends on the destination, that's it. For me, in my case, I'm happy to fly to the west because I love to fly to New York, for example, Los Angeles. I meet with WAMOS Air Los Angeles as well. As well, I flew to, of course, Cancun, Punta Cana, Santo Domingo, Aruba. But I remember my first flight here. That it was a setting flight for me because it was my first flight in 747-400 with a captain and a safety pilot as well. We had three pilots. It was from, do you remember, 11 years ago, we used to do flights for cruises, Pullman Tour cruises.
Sí, claro, of course.
The ships, the big ships. But I remember my first flight was from Madrid to Athens, going back.
To Athens.
I was very, very nervous, but it was excellent. It was a very nice flight. It was my
remember, go to Athens, they were with the three planes, eh?
With three planes, yeah.
So it's like 1,500 people to full.
And we flew on Thursday and as well on Saturday.
Yeah.
Two flights per week.
Not too much.
And as well we flew for Trondheim, for the cruises, for Venice. Very nice. Very nice. But actually, if I can choose, I would choose to fly to the Caribbean, you know? It's a very nice place to stay with very good weather.
But remember, about the jet lag. Not the same going to the west than going
to the
east.
Yeah, for me, I think it's worse going to the east than to the west. Eh?
See?
Yeah, for me, in my body, I feel more tired when I fly to the east than to the west.
To Asia.
To Asia, yeah.
Yeah, for me, I think it's the same.
That's it.
Yeah, because here we arrive now, it's nearly 11 o'clock in Spain, it's 6 o'clock, so if you wait a little bit hours, you can sleep.
Uh-huh.
You go to Asia, so difficult. I remember. So difficult to sleep. That's the only one of the small bad things of this job. Or what? I don't call a job, but of our what we do it.
Yeah, that's it.
The rest,
that's it.
It's perfect. Solo, 6 years old.
Because anybody in your family was a pilot or was a, something in the aviation?
My father.
Ah, your father?
Was military.
Ah, okay.
So he always took me to see the planes, to go to the aerodromes, but all military, eh?
Ah, military.
All military. And I love it. So since I was a small kid, he put me in the blood.
That's good.
The aviation. So
it's a dream done.
Yeah, because in my house they asked me, what you gonna do, Danny? I never say nothing. And they said, pilot, say, you crazy pilot. Why are you gonna be pilot? Why not?
Yeah, many people say, well, you pilot, but you are everybody outside the home, you can be a family. It's a mistake because you can do everything, but you have to be prepared for that, you know?
Yeah, that's true. And if there's no one in your family that is pilot, they say, why a pilot?
Yeah, in my case, nobody's pilot, I'm becoming a pilot, and everybody asking about. Everybody is like envy, like, okay, you are a pilot, wow, you are a pilot. But sometimes you say, okay, a pilot, you are every day outside at home. You cannot be in the birthday of your son. You have many good things and another not good thing. No bad things, because I hear not bad things.
There's no any perfect thing.
That's good. And we are very lucky because we fly the 747, Danny, 400.
Best plane.
That's it.
Best plane. It's like to be a doctor, no? If you want to be a doctor, have to be very.
Yeah.
No one can be a doctor. I cannot be a doctor. If I see blood, I.
But if imagine that, Danny, if for any case you cannot continue in aviation, so what would you do? You would be instructor in the ground, and then doing simulators, or you would do another job? You're looking for another job?
I don't know.
What would you do?
For sure, I will try to do simulators or this kind of things.
Okay.
For sure. Not to be a part of the aviation. And
so you will stay in aviation, right?
Yeah. But that's one thing I never saw and I never think before. I would like to sail boats.
Oh, good.
I like it. That's another thing.
Good. Sail boat, good.
But it only happened to me 2 years ago to think about it. And you?
This is a good question. I think if I cannot fly aircraft, I will dead.
No, I don't think
this is my life. No, actually, I like many things. For example, maybe I would like to be part of this business. Maybe as well working again in the office, in instruction department, doing class, ground school, for example, that I'm doing now. But as well, I would like the business regarding maybe I would like to be part of a project with a friend in order to, for example, doing a restaurant, for example. I like this kind of things. But maybe I will 50% aviation and 50% out of aviation. Maybe. That's it.
And I think the most lucky thing to be here in Guamos is I think in any other company we will never fly the places that we've been flying.
So we have just now received an ATC message, like a ping ATC message. ATC is asking us, when can you accept to climb flight 350? That's as we talked before. We're expecting to climb flight 350 now, and control told us if we can accept flight 350 now. So you don't mind, Danny, may what I accept it?
What do you think?
Okay, report. So, flight level 350 at 1711. So, we're going to accept to climb level 350 now. So, Zulu time is 1711. 1711 from now. Flight level 350, 1711. May I send? Sending, okay?
Okay.
And now, so we're waiting for the ATC. Re-clear us to climb to flight level 350.
So, this is like a WhatsApp, no?
Yeah, this is like a WhatsApp. We are in CPDC, Control Pilot Data Link Communication, and as well we are EDSZ, that means Automatic Dependent Surveillance Contract. So this is like this is for people flying here the graph and the people that is in the control. It's like a WhatsApp, like we send information from here. And we need the EDS, Automatic Dependent Surveillance, Model Charlie, Model Contract. This is a double via communication between control and us. I send a communication, and he has to answer in a period of maximum 400 seconds. This is that EDS means. And CPDC, Control Pilot Data Link Communications, this is part of FANS. FANS Future Navigation System, that's Data Link, ADS, and CPDLC. That's a small summary of this is ACAS, CPDLC, FANS.
No, the idea of this, they know, is before of that, we have only HF. And the way to reduce the communication loads and work, they... The next step is that.
Remember, it's 10 ago, all of us in Asia, had not ACARS. I had to contact with control with HFF. Yeah. I was impossible to communication with HFF. Very noisy, many aircraft, and now with the ACARS, we send ACARS with the CPDLC, and that's it. They say, okay, receive it. They can read. So this is not confusing because they can read that we write in the control display unit, and it's more easy for us and more easy for the control. As well the SATCOM, eh? Any problem we can call for SATCOM like a phone.
Yeah.
But this is part of the future navigation system that CPDLC, you need to do a logon, as well EDS, data link is mandate, you know, in the RVSN, reduce vertical separation minimize from flight level 290 to 410, from 20th of January, from 20 days, is mandatory for everybody that is flying from flight level 290 to 410, you have data link. If you have no data link, you cannot fly in Atlantic.
And it's like the vertical separation, no?
Maybe. As well, there is vertical, yeah, that's it.
More flights, that's the problem.
Say again?
More flights.
Yeah,
more flights flying.
Same place to fly, more aircraft.
That's it. So they have to improve.
Yeah. Actually, we need to stay here, a required navigation performance of 2.0, and the aircraft, a 747, actually 0.06 nautical miles. So this is accurate, it's very accurate navigation.
And we will get to 40 west, New York, no?
Yeah, we are 330 nautical miles south, 40 west, with contact with New York in 11396 and 13306.
So the idea of this, well, this is not too long, it's 8 hours, but the idea for long flights is to save fuel as much as you can.
That's
so
it.
That's why sometimes it's good to climb to save fuel, sometimes not because of the wind is more headwind, so we have to play with that, no?
But in this case, our optimum flight is flight level 348, and we are flight level 340, and we're looking for the 350 that will be optimum in 5-10 minutes.
That's it.
was working like a flight attendant.
Sí.
15 years ago.
Uh-huh.
I was here in Pullman Tour Air. Now it's Wamos Air because we changed the name. It was my familiarization flight, and while I doing the preparation and the demonstration for the passengers on board with the wake calls, with the exits, you know, somebody, I know perfectly who was, but somebody put in my wake calls with in the opposite side,
uh-huh.
Okay, and he was here. He's a new guy, okay, and all the passengers in the cockpit, in the cabin, applauding me because he put in here. This is new guy, please applaud it. When I was walking by the aisle, everybody is like applauding.
What
I didn't understand what happening. Everybody smiled with me, but in this moment it was not so funny. But I remember now. I remember now. It's remember with a very nice experience. Okay, with the flight attendant.
And now you told me. Now I remember. There was long time ago. I think when we do the Athens and Venezia and all that.
The flight from Madrid to Athens. Yeah.
See, and Venezia. Yes. We were doing a lot. I remember that season was summer. Was a lot of flights, going up Monday, Tuesday, Wednesdays, I remember. And I remember I was sitting on the right side, and the captain was a foreign captain. He was a foreign guy. He said, "Hey, Danny, can you make a speech about where we are going and all that kind of things?" So in Spanish, I said, "Okay, no problem." And I remember doing this speech, and the first scene, we were flying from Madrid to Athens.
Yeah.
And I said, "Well, welcome on board this flight to Venice."
You're going to Athens and you say, Venice. You told Venice, oh.
And all people were, what the fuck? Venice, no, Venice, Venice, yeah. Venice. We went to Athens. And was very funny. All the players was shouting and doing everything. I say, "Daniel, what'd you say?" Say, "I make a mistake. I thought it was Venice. I went to Athens." Something like that. The cabin crew were calling us. Everyone.
Hey, Danny, are you sure that we're going to Athens or to Venice?
Yeah.
So imagine, Danny, that you have to choose one of our destinations that Wamos Air has to live there.
Ah, to live?
To live. For example, you know that Wamos Air has more than 140 destinations during this 60 years old.
I know.
You can choose. What place would you like to live?
Punta Cana.
Punta Cana, eh? Because what the weather or what?
Everything. Weather, people.
People, yeah.
Place.
They're very friendly, the people of Punta Cana, right?
Yes. And you?
I think as well Punta Cana. I like Punta Cana. But for example, place like Jakarta is very nice.
It's
but
nice.
It's different.
It's different. It's another thing.
Los Angeles is very nice, but it's different. New York is a city that is amazing. But Punta Cana?
For living, Punta Cana.
Punta Cana. Again, we are here and we continue over Atlantic, flight level 360, expecting climb to flight level 380 in 10 minutes from now. We are almost approaching leaving of FIRO New York and going to San Juan de Puerto Rico. We have now we are lucky because we have a tailwind, 4 or 5 knots of tailwind. So our ground speed is 500 knots, so we are fast. We continue flying to Mach 84, and the time is we are 6 hours 10 flight time. The total time will be today is 8 hours, so just 1 hour and 50 minutes to reach Punta Cana. That's a very nice flight, no turbulence at all, good meal, good Coca-Cola, and good conversation with Daniel Canino.
Same to me.
So now Danny, the captain is going to tell you something interesting.
Something very important.
Something very important, of course. And after that I will tell you something about the system of the aircraft, more generally about the autopilot, about the pressurization, about the hydraulics, about the engines, but to you know more how the 747-400 is inside.
Yeah, a general view of the plane, no?
That's it.
More or less.
But general, eh?
General. Well, I must say only Patrick, the one of our clip, told me to say this because he has warned that our video was, it will be a view for a lot of people. So, just he told me about if we get the at least the million, maybe it's 20 million. If we get at least 1 million,
oh, wow.
From the a good up thumb, he will, how you say in English, he say it's a lucky drone.
A lucky drone, okay.
Or lottery.
Lottery, yeah.
Lucky drone. He will, in lucky drone, he will give this maqueta from Wamos 747 from the My Delta Sierra. It's one of another plane that we have it, 747, to all the people who say that they like the video until the 1 million. So in the 1 million, the first 1 million, he will give this marvelous plane of Wamos to one of them. Okay.
And as well with the website of.
Also, the website is AirClick.
AirClick, okay, and Wamos Air.
That's
okay,
it.
That's it.
Vale?
And Danny, one question. That's we have the excellent 747-400 that we have right now. If I wanna turn left now with the autopilot on, how you do?
Well,
we are now, and I have to go to left side.
Adrian, I think better on without this. Explain with this.
Okay.
So we can leave it here, and we explain.
I put the maqueta here.
Yeah. So we can explain about this, no?
Yes. Just kidding about the how we can manage the 747 with the autopilot.
No, I mean, nearly it's like a, well, it's not like a car because it's three dimensions, but we can turn in with this, right?
Uh-huh.
We can push it down also, and we can push it up.
Okay, and if I want to do like this?
Well, that is more difficult, no?
Imagine that it's a small airplane.
Maybe it's, if it's military, maybe you can
I'm
do
kidding.
It.
I'm kidding.
General views. How we start? With this one, no? For example, engines. No?
Yeah.
Engines, as we see, we have four engines, and they have different parameters.
Yeah.
Okay? So we have vibration of part of the engines, oil quantity. It's like a car, no?
That's
oil.
It.
Temperature, pressure, of course, if it's a liquid,
uh-huh.
We have quantity, temperature, and pressure, okay? And then...
And one important thing now, that's for select, this is the ACAS, upper ACAS, and this is lower ACAS, okay?
It.
And, for example, now, you can see in the fuel flow, Danny, that we are 2.4 per engine, so it's approximately 10 tons per hour, the fuel consumption.
That's it.
All the systems, all the screens, we can manage with the AFIS, for in this case, engine or air pressure, for example. The fuel page here, and we can see in the ACAS lower, all the fuel page with the total fuel remaining, 31 tons for Punta Cana.
And for each tank?
And the fuel in every tank. Main tank 1, 2, 3, 4, reverse, and we have not today fuel in the stop, and now in the center. Danny, what do you think for our visitors if we climb to flight level 380? We are now 360, and we can do a
here.
Cruise climb. Okay, happy? Okay, I'm going to request, if you don't mind.
But we were clear, no?
Yeah, we're already clear, but I'm going to show you how we did it. So, first of all, this is an ACAR that I told you before, and with a CBDLC, Control Pilot Link Communication, I'm going to request climb to flight level 380. Now we are maintaining flight level 360 and request 380. So we go to request. We put here the altitude 380. Okay, and we send to control. Okay, we have to wait for 1 or 2 minutes and receive an answer in order we are clear to climb flight level 380 or not. In this case, we already are clear for climb to flight level 380. And Danny, anytime you can cruise climb.
Okay. So
okay.
We are clear. We say
so.
Climb to reach.
In this moment, guys, we are here, and we are going to climb like this to 80, 2000 feet, 600 meters. Does it thrust rev, VNAV speed 30?
Check.
And look at the four engines go to climb power and the aircraft with the autopilot on starting the climb to flight level 380.
Check.
The rate now, you can see here in the primary flight display, is 1,200 feet per minute to reach flight level 380.
Also, I can say, for example, we can change the mode to vertical speed, for example.
This is another mode. The vertical speed is another
change
mode
to 800, for example.
Flight director and autopilot. Now they change for speed and for vertical speed.
That's it.
And now the rate is put here for Danny, 800 feet per minute, that we can see here. And as well, the ES indicator, we can set in IS or a MAC. 1,000, Danny?
1,000.
Another flight level is flight level change, Danny. You can set a flight level change. So the speed intervention is operate because it's automatic. The speed will be the same. But the mode in the auto throttle mode that's in the left side is thrust instead of speed. And in the right side, instead of vertical speed, is flight level change.
That's it.
This is another mode to climb the 747-400.
Flight level change, VNAV or vertical
that's
speed.
That's it.
Then we can explain, well, easily about pressurization, temperature of the cabins, the Alpha, Bravo, Charlie, Delta.
And here Danny told us with the pressing ECS, that means environment control system, in the ACAS lower, you can see what? You can see the temperature of the flight deck. Flight deck temperature and upper deck temperature. How we can change? We can change the temperature with these switches, past temperature and flight deck. And as well, the senior can modify the temperature downstairs. We can put it on from 18 degrees to 290 degrees, and the senior can change 6 degrees above or below from the temperature that we present here. As well, we have the temperature for cabins, Alpha, Bravo, Charlie, Delta, Echo. Alpha is here downstairs, and Echo is the tail. And as well, the temperature of the cargo doors.
And if I change this, which is the passenger temperature, the master, it will go down, or it will go up.
That's it.
So normally we put it on the middle to get the degrees.
As well, we can check the outflow valves. They are here, and they are here. The outflow valves must be open in ground and close, sure, in air. This is for control the pressurization, okay? And we can select and manage from here. This is the environment control system, air systems, and filter. And we can check and select that we put here, in here, with the PAX control, bleed pressure, bleed indication, duct pressure, everything here. You can see here. We can manage here, touch here, and we can see here.
So we say that everything that is here, we can see in different panels. Fuel panel is this one, which is this. ECS is this, which is this. And then we have the hydraulic, which is this. All this, the moves of the plane, the ailerons, speed brakes, gear, primary flight display, primary controls, secondary controls, flaps, all goes with hydraulic.
Okay.
So it's the better way to move a surface, no?
Yeah. And basically, this aircraft is in case of any problem, you have any redundancy because it's four hydraulic systems, four engines, four generators, and this is a very, very comfortable or very safe for us.
That's
here,
it.
You can see the electronic engine control here, the inertial IRS, as well APU and batteries, all electric system, all hydraulic systems, emergency lights. This is for the bottles as well. This is for the ignitions and engine starts. as well for all the system, the field systems, nacelle system, there's the anti-ice systems, window heats, all the lights operations. This is all those operations. As we briefed before, is the environment control system, pressurizations, temperatures, the circulation fans, pressure, bleed, MCP, mode control panel, AFIS left side, AFIS right side. And don't forget, guys, to visit us in Guam Air and
AirClick,
and to enter with a lottery of this magnificent 747-400 market. That's it. It's nice, huh? It's nice.
You want to
like a ship.
Like a ship.
It's like a ship. Wow. So, guys, thank you, all of you. And we talk in 1 hour before the top of the thing in order to prepare with you the briefing for our arrival at Punta Cana Airport. Will be our GNS arrival for runway 08. The wind, the weather is okay, so we talk later about this.
Some clouds,
yep.
But not too much important. About the briefing,
yes.
If we go to the chart of Punta Cana, first of all, we put the star, no?
Yeah.
Which is the?
It's a Petit One Whiskey arrival for runway 08.
Runway 08, we have Petit One Whiskey.
That's it.
It says that is Betir One Whiskey. Sorry, one moment, please. Okay, Betir, that's it here. Max 250-160.
Check.
Mixar 230-150.
Check.
Below, of course. And Berel is 220-120,000.
Check.
And then we have the PC-099, which is 224,000.
Yes, a check as well.
Okay, and then we have the point Agnal, which is here set.
Check.
Okay, we born on expand mode.
Berel,
PC-099, and Agnal.
340,
is the 408 arrival, okay?
Yeah. Okay, Agnal, we have a speed of maximum 210 knots, right?
Uh-huh.
And 3000, that is already set, thank you.
But, so next step is the approach chart. 12-1,
check.
Minimum sector.
Is it pretty for you because it's
3,800
feet, well?
3,000.
Okay.
And you put it on fixed. That's posted on fixed.
It's the fix, yes. In the,
okay. Nicely. For the chart of approach, we have the Aeronav GNS 08, which says Agnal. Here, after Agnal, go by the 177 minimum 3000 to Dapna, which
check.
Is this point. Dapna.
5
and after Dapna,
yeah.
We have to descend to Rikit, is 17,000.
Check.
And from Rikit is the FAB. So we have to make a continuous descent.
Okay.
To our minimums, 3.03 degrees, okay? 140 knots will be like 750.
Puma 26008 heavy.
Okay, 280.
I say, Kevin, can you start this one? Kevin, can you start this one?
Puma 6008,
descend and maintain 280. Okay, descend and maintain 28, apply 280, Puma 6008.
Trap in a speed, seatbelt zone.
Okay.
Cabin descent, perfect.
Check.
Then,
Minimums.
Danny, front, speed up speed, 2-0-1-8, okay?
Minimums 7:30 set. And then for the go around, it says it's here, climb to Power 2257 on track 087. Left arm climbing to.
Hold.
Check. 258, proceeded to Arnal. And holding at Arnal.
Okay?
Okay?
Check.
So, we're gonna put the point of Darna.
I'm putting for you, you want for Rikik, but you can change anytime.
Ah, Rikik.
In the FAF.
Okay,
2 miles out.
2 miles, perfect.
Carrying 130.7, take care.
And you told me about the taxi.
Yeah, taxi arriving by 08, hotel taxiway is closed. We take Alpha or Papa, depends.
Okay, check.
To Alpha, holding point. Auto brakes 3,
check.
And remember to check also to
RMP, okay?
RMP.
I will check it.
And to be 4, then 1,
yeah.
And then 0, 3 for the GPS approach.
Okay.
19-4, you have a good
day. Understood, flat 30.
Flat 30.
And speed 144, that I,
yeah.
Okay.
144,
thank you.
Check.
This is speed 144 for 30. Okay, Danny, so are you happy with the descent checklist?
Go ahead.
Descent checklist, briefing, MCA minimas.
Complete and check.
Complete and check. BRF.
Flat 30, 144.
Flat 30, speed 144. Auto brakes.
3.
Recall.
Recall.
It's clear, okay? Descent checklist, okay, copy, Danny.
So it's 4 less, it's 254. Sorry. 2-5-2-1-4-4-1-4-4. Perfect. Okay. Copy that. So we check the altitude, the restriction, the points.
Yeah, everything.
To be mandatory and then to approach the Dakna Rig.
Condor, 950.
You see the descent from the kick 3.13. Good afternoon, descent. It's Makana speaking. Just for information, we are going to start the descent to Punta Cana, 27 degrees, and as it is currently clear. Thanks for your attention and all.
You back?
Si.
Okay, no change. Continue to send the flight level 380.
Okay.
I have the radio.
You have the radio.
1,000. Okay, Danny, it's information uniform. Runway 08, 1208 knots. 27 degrees, QNH 2991.
Vale, fuera, mamá.
I'm back. My radio?
Copy.
Condor 103, registers are made. Contact you with Eric 130.7. Have a good day.
Condor 103, Eric on 130.7. So long, Tim.
Holding 6008, cross the pitch here. Had to maintain flight level 130, descent 1 ready.
Okay, gravity flight level 130.6008. So we are descending to Punta Cana Airport. We are now descending for flight level 380 to flight level 280. We are maintaining flight level 280. And we land in about 20 minutes from now. The runway is 08 in Punta Cana. The weather is okay. So some showers in the vicinity. And we are to perform the GNS approach for runway 08. And nothing more special. So see you in a while in the April.
American Soul 93, contact Miami Center 126.45. Have a good night. Holman 6008, registers our turn made. Contact put the counter approach 119.75. Have a great day.
1175, have a good day too. Thank you, Puma 6008. 1175. Punta Cana Control, buenas tardes, Papa Lima 600 Heavy, descending to flight level 130 to Petir.
Pullman Tour 600E, Punta Cana approach. Radar contact 40 miles northeast of Petir. After Petir, direct to Papa Charlie 0999.
Okay, after Petir, direct to Papa Charlie 0999, Pullman 6008.
After Betir.
I put for you.
No,
Papa Charlie 009.
Check.
After Betir, make confirm. Execute.
Check.
Executing.
Put the count approach to the 331 out of 175 for NSX 10,000. We have uniform.
Blue 331 Punta Cana approach. Radar contact. Respect runway 08 QNA.
So after Betir, Papa Charlie.
Center 2, after Antex, we'd like to request direct an EB for the 08 RNF.
KBLU-331, Roger, we have your request.
Thank you. Danny, passing transition, okay?
Check.
He said, transition said passing 175.
Top. Equal.
Okay, okay.
So, approach.
Yeah, approach checklist. It's cabin signs.
On.
Inboard land lights on.
On.
Altimeters, tune in and I want. Set a cross check. Approach check is complete.
Thanks. Close to the airport, we see how the clouds are, okay? The
okay.
Weather conditions and all that.
So you're going to speed. You have now here inside.
Yeah.
This is a... You going to maintain this speed, Danny, or you going to 270, for example? Or you going to maintain 300?
Tell before to go to the left with the heading to avoid, right?
Okay. Punta Cana Pullman 6008 requests 20 degrees left in order to avoid.
270.
That deviation is approved.
Approved, Pullman 6008. Okay, heading speed 270, thank you. Approved.
Check.
Okay.
Heading 7.
Check.
Salida, buenas tardes, Taca Perú 971 en ascenso 1 para hoy.
What a beautiful is the aviation, Dani.
Continúe la salida.
What a beautiful is the aviation.
2 Whiskey. Continúe Pesca 2 Whiskey y su ascenso a 1-4000 sin restricción. 1-4000 en la salida, ¿me confirma? ¿Podríamos producir por derecha Pesca?
Luego de 2010 derecha directo Pesca aprobado.
2000 derecha Pesca, muy mal.
Also, you can say them to. Proceed to the point, Papa Charlie.
Okay, after that, right? Or now?
Now, because there's nothing.
Punta Cana Pullman 603.
Station calling.
This is Papa Lima Mike 6008 Heavy, approaching level, approaching 13000. Request possible to present position directly to Papa Charlie 099 for weather. Punta Cana Pullman 6008 Heavy.
Thinking about.
Check.
He's thinking.
Yeah, say again. It's a Pullman 6008 requesting proceed direct from present position to Papa Charlie 099 because of weather.
Cleared as request. Pullman 6008.
Clear the request. Thank you, Pullman 6008. Papa Charlie 099 on top. Enough available, may execute?
Check.
Execute. Enough.
Pullman Tour 6008, descienda a 6010.
Pullman 6008, descending to
6,000
feet.
Tell him to maintain this altitude for 1 minute,
okay.
For clouds.
Pullman 6008, because of weather, we need to maintain 3,000 feet for 1 minute because of weather.
Approve.
Thank you, sir. We approve, okay? And then to 6,000, Danny.
Check. Heading cell a little bit to the right.
Check. Now it's clear, right? Good.
Yeah. But better to maintain this altitude for a while. Okay, now you can put it direct, please.
Papa Charlie 099.
Check.
On top, execute.
Check.
Caperu 971, comunique Santo Domingo en 1278.
Calaf.
Edna Green.
278, buenas tardes.
Papa Charlie 799, Magenta.
Check. Anytime for 6,000 feet.
W331, Punta Cana.
6,000?
Yes, fly heading 26.
We're calling 27.
Descend to 6,000 feet. 260, heading out, descend 6,000, W331.
Harbina speed.
Harbina speed, 6,000 feet.
Check. Tell him that we are descending to 6,000.
A Punta Cana, Puma 6008, we're starting out descend from 6,000 feet. Thank you.
Roger.
Good. I'm gonna put 250.
Check.
Okay?
Yes, I'm gonna check in the approach. Now it's Recon Navigation
DB,
Program
DB,
1, okay?
And the two DBs.
So we need a 0.03 for the approach, okay? But now in arrival is 1.07 off.
Copy. This is the best part of the flight, eh?
That's, yeah.
When we arrive.
Yeah.
And we see the coast.
Yeah.
Huh?
If you want, I can put in on Papa Charlie 099, 4,000, instead of 4,000 above.
Okay.
Because it's much, much upgrade. Because of the BTK is already...
Also, you can do it with... Dafna rigged, put at the same altitude. 3,017.
Yeah, okay, that's 210/3,000. Set.
And 17 the same.
And for Ricky, that's okay, but it will be a pop up to you. You want it as well?
Do it.
Okay, 170/17,000. Ricky, may execute?
Check.
Is it the BTK?
Because Ricky is the point of descent. So we're gonna can level off 17 and then descend.
Okay, is Papa Charlie 4,000? We are a little higher.
Machine sometimes slow.
The lights are okay, okay?
Copy.
I think it's okay. And then the phone. I want to switch on the lagoon as well.
But we have them 3,000, like
yes,
exactly. 5 miles.
Yeah. We're standing by for clearance, but initially it's Papa Charlie 099-4000.
Sure. So really, we are not so high.
Ten thousand, Danny. Oh.
Starting approach.
Coming crew, starting approach.
Thank you.
Pullman 26008, say speed.
Pullman 6008, 240 knots.
We use to 200. Descend to 3000 clear for an approach, 08 approach.
Runway 08, Pullman 6008. Speed check.
JetBlue 331, Tower 1.
So 3000, check. 200 knots.
Check.
Bacana.
Send for you here, 200 knots.
Okay.
Thank you. For the VTK.
Norland, 1A radar contact, left, direct to Zuma, climb to flight level 170.
Climbing 170, direct to Zuma, Norland, 518. Thank you.
I'm gonna put terrain, okay?
Okay.
Because it's
amazing weather.
Cana, buenas tardes. Noviembre 133, Romeo Charlie, directo down, y 6000.
133, Romeo Charlie, está en contacto radar, continúe descenso a 4000 pies, volando a Daphna.
4000 Daphna, y tenemos a ti a bordo.
Recibido.
Descending flight level 140 in Mount Antics.
Speed in a path.
Check.
Condor 950 Punta Cana approach, Roger. Radar contact at 30 miles northeast of Antics.
1000.
After Antics, direct to Emupo. After Antics.
Idle Vina speed.
Check.
Condor 950 after Antics, direct Emupo.
Correct.
Condor 950 request.
Go ahead.
Condor 950, we try to coordinate before to get a straight in for the ANAF runway 29 in La Romana.
We have your request.
We have to put the wing. Remember that.
Okay, sorry, is the wing on?
Good.
Speed in a path.
Check. Speed in a path.
So next altitude
will
be Ricky
1700. Direct Lima, Romeo
490
for the ANAF runway 29.
Okay, so
3000
minute
path. Check.
Batman 518, request heading 060 due to weather.
Did you go to check in?
This is Flatland 518, we are requesting heading 060 due to weather in the vicinity of Chuma Point. And Condor 950, request after Antics direct Lima Romeo 4
of the runway side.
0 for the gradient ANAF runway 29.
I'll stand by 950. Norland 518,
Punta Cana. We request heading 060 due to weather, Flatland 518.
Heading 060 is approved.
So in case of go around, climb Papa Charlie 257, track 87. On the left, climbing to Papa Charlie 258.
FIA, ACNAD, hold, yes, he's in the box.
What do you say again? Good.
Now heading off 1177.
177. Another plane, 518. Could you say again frequency, please?
Flap 10.
Have a standby one. Check.
Pullman 6008, contact tower 118, Pullman 6008, bye. Tarde de Punta Cana, buenas tardes, Pullman 6008, heavy, 3000 feet for GNS runway 08.
Pullman 6008, good evening, Tarana Tower, you continue approach, runway, wind 1403 at 5 and QNH 29993.
QNH 29993, we continue approach runway, 08 Pullman 6008.
2993, and I said 17,000.
Tune in, that's what I said.
Okay?
Okay, 1,000. Okay, check. Require, recording vision performance 0.03, actual 0.04.
Thanks. Echo pista 08 via Echo Rusa pista 9.
Apunte espera 08 via Echo, tercer cruce 09, copa 351.
Then, heading for final is 087, on the left.
Okay, and that now to start the descent for final prefix, Rickett.
And hold turn on runway 9.
Alpha, hold turn 9, JetBlue 331.
Just near the cloud.
Yeah. Temperature plus 25.
Check.
And JetBlue 3319 said, continue taxing back Kilo Bravo, cross Niner, and hold short of Echo.
Kilo Bravo, hold short of Echo, JetBlue 3321, and we could cross runway 9.
Avianca 253, listo al final.
Afirmativo, Avianca 253.
Okay, descending.
Okay. Approaching glide path.
Minimum 800.
Check. Sugar Pisa 08, Avianca 253, gracias.
Approaching glide path, ok, Dani.
Gear down, plus 20.
Landing it down. Flaps 20.
Check.
Is check. The one way side. And good. The mix approach altitude done today will be 3,000.
Okay. Let's pass in this altitude and I will set it.
Okay.
Runway inside.
Yeah.
JetBlue 331,
Puppy inside.
Puppy inside and RP 0.30, actual 0.04.
Check. Pullman 6008, runway 08. Clear land, wind 1403 is 5 knots.
Clear to land, runway 08, Pullman 6008, thank you.
Clear to land.
Okay. The wing is from the right. Now it's 40 knots, okay?
Yeah. So, Ricky. It's 3,000, right?
Yeah, 3,000 feet, mission approach altitude.
Okay. 3,000 set.
Okay.
And as they told us, 3,000.
Avianca 253 contact, salida en
green. It's not really on the same, so flat 30.
Speed check. Flat 30. And you're clear to land.
And landing checklist.
It's landing checklist. Cabin is ready, speed brake.
Arm.
Gear.
Down green.
Down green. Flaps.
30 green.
After disconnect, flight director, cabin ready. Landing check is cabin is ready. Landing check is complete, okay?
Okay.
And you are clear to land. The wing is from the upper here, you want? Continue. Okay. Once the landing check is complete, I'm ready to set.
Flight director off.
Okay.
Número 133, Romeo Charlie, buenas noches, Punta Cana. Recibido, continua aproximación, pista 08.
Check.
Viento 130 grados, 6 nudos, QNH 2993.
Okay. Viento 110, 10 nudos.
Check.
Romeo Charlie. Alete from the right.
Put in your side legs.
Legs my side.
Landing check is complete, no? Clear
yeah,
to land.
Everything is complete.
Cruzando 09, compa 351.
Recibido.
Uno, uno, cero, cinco, uno, dos.
Check.
100. Falcon
9, Rebels of 30, 20, can...
Pivot up.
Check.
Okay.
Close. Manual braking.
Auto brakes.
Check.
Pullman 6008, welcome back. Continue exit by Alpha. Cross runway 9 and taxi to position number 2.
Okay, thank you, sir. Via Alpha, clear to cross runway 09 and to position stand number 2, Pullman 6008. Thank you. Well done, Danny. Well done. Gael, which lights you want?
Outboard out.
November 133,
Charlie. For once in a year.
Again?
For once in a year. For once in a year.
Yeah.
Superficie, buenas tardes, compa 242. En la Bravo 24, solicitar retroceso y encendido de motores.
Compa 242, recibido retroceso y encendido de motores, aprobado.
Aprobado, retroceso encendido, compa 242.
So you're clear to cross,
thank you.
Runways unite. And stand number 2.
Okay.
The door of the APU is open.
Thanks.
Welcome to our International Airport, Punta Cana, where the local time is 6 p.m. and the outside temperature is 23 degrees Celsius. For safety reasons, remain seated with your seatbelt fastened, and the aircraft has come to a complete stop, and the illuminated seatbelt sign has been turned off. Please be careful when opening the overhead lockers, as some luggage may have moved during landing. When disembarking, please remember to take all your personal belongings with you. We also remind you that it's not permitted to smoke or use electronic cigarettes until you reach the authorized area in the terminal. Your electronic devices may remain turned off and until the aircraft has come to a complete stop. When disembarking from the aircraft, please have your passport ready, together with the documentation you fill it during the flight for inspection by the police at the door of the aircraft. On behalf of Wamoser, Captain Daniel Canino, and all the crew, we thank you for having flown with us on this occasion, and we look forward to seeing you on board again. Thank you and good afternoon.
Okay, approaching runway 09.
Check.
We have a traffic inside, but it's for runway 08, I think. Okay.
Copy.
I put in the strop on.
Right clear.
Yeah, the right clear, Danny.
Left clear.
Going for 08. Strap off. Speed is 50 knots.
Yeah. So number 2, eh?
Yeah, it's number 2, Danny.
This is the Julio Iglesias Airport.
Please don't tell Julio Iglesias. I'm going to cry. Me emociono.
Copa 351, fuera de posición, mantenga pista 8.
Mantenga pista 08, Copa 351.
Ok. So, number 2, people waiting.
May I switch on the view?
Yeah. Switch on.
Número 133, Romeo Charlie, bienvenido a Punta Cana.
Otra vez, Charlie.
Otra pista en alza y confirme, se dirige hacia rampa FBO o VIP.
El 3 Romeo Charlie abandona pista vía alfa al
number 1.
Okay.
Uno recibe Romeo
Charlie.
Number 2. Ok. La ciudad continúa vía alfa, cruza pista nueva, sea rampa VIP. Feliz noche.
You check your side, check my side.
Gracias, cruzamos pista 9 al VIP.
Good play pressure. Romeo Charlie. Lights are on.
Pull off. Now we done it. Up you running, put it on bar.
Okay, in bar. The race clear.
Copa 351, pista 08, autorizado a despegar, viento 130 grados, 7 nudos.
Autorizado a despegar, pista 08, copa 351.
Check.
EP on bars, okay, race clear.
At your side.
Yes, clear.
My side, clear.
A los 858, bueno, apuntado a la velocidad.
Señores, estamos listos, siguiendo puesta en marcha y listo a copiar hacia... Tango November Charlie Charlie. Superficie Copa 242, listo, rodaje con yendo forma.
Copa 242, rodaje punto espera. Eco pista 08, vía Eco, cruce pista 9.
Ya Eco punto de espera, pista 08, trazado cruce, pista 09, Copa 242.
Y ahora domingo 858, pendiente, 30 segundos para autorización.
Copiado, estamos recibiendo puesta en marcha.
Aprobado, discreción.
Discreción,
índice de marcha.
No. Ok. Parking break. Set.
Copa 351, contacte salida en 19751.
Check. Engines.
5 minutes, ok.
1, yeah, 5 minutes. 2, 3. Yeah, off. Shutdown
check. Shutdown check is a park brake.
Is set.
Engine rundown.
Now decreasing. Normal.
Seatbelt signs.
Sorry?
Seatbelt signs.
Off.
Demand pumps.
And off. Yokes.
Fuel pumps.
Off.
Steer lights. Is the wing and navigation on. Okay.
Okay. Apagadas.
Flaps.
Up.
Status.
Status. Up you running and the rest is
okay. The check is complete. Thank you very much, Danny. Pleasure.
Thanks. Thanks to everyone. It was a pleasure to show the plane, the flight, the crew and everything. For me it was a pleasure to fly with Adrian.
For me, so, with Danny. Thank you very much, all of you.
Yeah.
I expect that you enjoyed the flight with us. And we are now in stand in Punta Cana. Disembarking. And it was a pleasure. Thank you very much, and I expect to see you in the next flex.
In Guamos.
In Guamos, in the 747-400.
Thank you very much for everything.
Bye.
Bye-bye.